I'm Princy and welcome back to my channel Angst Cadbury. Hope you all are doing great and hope you all are comfortable out here. So today I am back with in my AA hair fall series, Friday hair fall series. I have been completed 3 episodes of my Friday hair fall series. If you have not yet watched this series, then I will be linking down the links in the description box or in this I button. Do go and watch it right now. And after watching this video only, so now I am on the hair fall series, Friday hair fall series, hashtag number 4. So in this episode, I will be debunking the myths which are concerning related to hair fall, and of course it is going on from our ancestors days. So I will be discussing certain myths about hair fall and just let you know what are the myths concerning hair fall. You might be also hearing about this myths from your mommy, daddy or anyone in your family. So if you're interested in it, do watch this video. And of course, we, along with this myths, I will be discussing again 3 recipes, homemade remedies or homemade recipes for treating your hair fall at home. And of course, thank you for all your support for all the other series, that is the suntan series and acne series, and of course now this hair fall series. And thank you for all this good lovely response for this hair fall series. Hope this series is helping out you guys. And without any further ado, now let's move on to this video. And before moving on to this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below in order to stay tuned to Angst Cadbury, and do hit the bell icon near the subscribe button in order to get future notification of my upcoming videos and you don't miss any important and interesting and informational videos of mine. So moving on to today's video now. There is something genetically wrong with you. So let me make it clear that having a hair fall is not completely genetic. It is not that you are genetically having something wrong in that your X or Y chromosomes. So believe in yourself and of course try this homemade remedy. So next time if someone gives you the reason that you are washing your hairs more often, so you are getting hair fall or excessive hair fall, then you have a reason to laugh at them, because excessive hair wash can lead your hair to dryness and brittle, but they will not cause as adverse hair fall or a premature hair fall that I am talking about. And yes, 50 to 100 strands of hair fall is completely normal, but more than that is something that you need to concern and should be treated out soon. So make sure that and of course if you are not washing your hair when it is dirty, then it will always lead to hair fall, because your scalp is dirty and your dirty scalp can lead to adverse hair fall also. So if someone is saying that if you are washing your hairs too often or you are washing your hairs very much and this is the cause of your hair fall, then this is not, it is always a myth, because washing your hair more than enough will make your hair look dry and brittle but not cause adverse or premature hair fall. So brushing your hair leads to hair fall is another myth that we are following, and yes, it is completely a myth. If you brush your hair too often, it will help in just distributing the natural oils of our hair to throughout the scalp, and also it will help in massaging your scalp. But more than enough brushing is harmful, because it will make our hair look more frizzy, but it will not create adverse hair fall or premature hair loss. So we all love having fun with our hairs. We go for perming, blow drying, straightening, coloring and trying various other colors. This is not a major cause of the excessive or adverse hair fall that I am talking about. To a certain extent, if you are doing in large amount, then it may cause hair fall in you. So if you are doing it on a regular basis, that is once in a month, twice in a month, then it may go for a hair fall issue. But if you are doing once in a year or once in 6 months, it will not create a huge mess of the hair fall I am talking about. So make sure to take care of your hairs and just avoid some artificial hair coloring, perming or straightening very often. So last but not the least, shaving your head. Yes, this myth was followed by my mom also. I am a victim of this myth that shaving your hairs give you a thicker hair and a head full of more hairs, and it is not. My mom shaved my hair 3 times when I was child. Every 3 months she used to shave my hairs and put up a pack of this sesame seeds, black sesame seeds, and just give it like that, or teal seeds. She used to make a paste of it, and of course Brahmi powder. I still remember how she and my aunt used to put a pack on my hair after shaving my head, but it is completely a myth. My hairs remained the texture and quality that I had in my hair when I was born. So it is not that shaving your head will give you a head of fuller hairs and of course make your hair look thicker and thicker and thicker. So it is completely a myth. That is all about the myth that I have been hearing when I was born, and now also I have been hearing my moms now also tell me that don't go for hair straightening, don't go do this with your hairs, you have destroyed all your hairs, your hair was so beautiful straight, and look at your hairs now. So these were all the myths that are being covered up in our brains of our mom, grandmother and everyone. So I am busting out the myths in these videos, hope this had helped you out. And now moving on to the three homemade remedies by which you can take care of your hairs and reduce your adverse hair fall.
Amla or Indian gooseberry oil is very beneficial in preventing hair fall and early graying. All you have to do is take some amla oil and massage it all over our hairs and keep it for overnight and then wash it off in the morning. Instead of using ready-made amla oil, you can also make your amla oil at home by using dried amla or gooseberry and just heating up this in a coconut oil and boil it and filter it after when it is cool and then use it regularly to prevent hair fall. If you want me to make another video of how to make a homemade amla oil, then do let me know by commenting on the comment section below so that I can record this recipe and upload it for you guys. So for our next recipe, we will be using hibiscus powder, which is very good for our hairs. Instead of this hibiscus powder, you can also use the fresh hibiscus flowers. Then in order to make this powder, I will be taking around 2 to 3 tablespoons of coconut oil, and to this I will be mixing 1 tablespoon of hibiscus powder. Hibiscus powder is a good natural hair conditioner and moisturizer making, which makes the hair soft and healthy. It is also effective for dry and limp hair. So all you have to do is apply this hibiscus powder and coconut paste onto our hairs and then allow it to remain for next 20 to 25 minutes, then rinse it off with water as normal. Last but not the least, our last homemade remedy is lemon juice. Yes, we have to cut the lemon and prepare a cup of lemon juice. And just to this, in order to dilute the juice, we will be mixing equal quantity of water to it. You can add cold water or you can also add warm water. And after bath, we can rinse our hair with this liquid lemon juice, or you can apply it on with the help of a cotton ball onto your hair scalp and then massage it and leave it for next 5 to 10 minutes and then wash it off your hair as normally you do. You can repeat this home remedy once or twice in a week, and lemon juice are excellent astringent. They tighten the pores in our scalp, thereby controlling hair fall. If you have oily hair, a lemon juice rinse is what you can try out for your best result. Lemons also contain alpha hydroxylic acid that exfoliates dead cells, eliminating dandruff in the process. Lemons are rich in vitamin C and essential nutrients that helps maintain hair health. Despite all these goodies, lemon juice contains acid, hence close your eyes as you pour the mixture over your head. Also remember not to use lemon juice remedy too frequently or for a long duration, it can dry out your hair.
So that's it for the video. Hope this video was really very helpful to you. So stay tuned to other two episodes of the Hair Fall series. So two episodes of the Hair Fall series are still remaining, and thank you for all these lovely comments and the support in this Hair Fall series. And this is why I had taken a bit long time in uploading this Hair Fall series, because I want this Hair Fall series to be really very effective for you guys, and I have tried this all these homemade remedies. So if this video has helped you out a lot, and if you like the homemade remedies, then do hit the like button down below, because liking a video, sharing a video, commenting on a video or subscribing to your channel is completely free, but it means a lot to me and it is out of cost. So please, it doesn't go anything, no, doesn't go from your pocket. So please hit that like button down below in order to or I appreciate the hard work I am putting into my videos. And moreover, share this video with your friends and relatives near and dear ones, anyone which is in need of this hair fall series. Share this video with your friends and relatives because I believe sharing is caring. So till my next video, love you, take care, bye, and do hit that subscribe button in order to stay tuned to Angst Cadbury so that you don't miss up my upcoming important, useful and interesting videos. So till my next video, love you, take care and bye.